Today's speaker, Shri R. Gopinath ji. Gopinath ji is an international speaker. Till 2006, he was the CEO and the MD of LIC Lanka, but gave up all that to become a full-fledged trainer, a consultant, and a strategic coach. He has addressed many international seminars and many such conventions. He was the first Indian to earn that privilege. In Macau, he addressed 6,000 financial advisors from all over the world. In the Bangkok Convention, as the main platform speaker, he addressed 8,000 financial advisors. And at the Singapore Agency Management Conference, he addressed 800 managers from top organizations. He is also a personal strategic coach for few chief executive officers, top management, presidents, senior executives, sportsmen, and the list is endless. With this, I would like you to join me with loud applause and welcome an excellent trainer, a great coach, a motivational guru, and international speaker, Shri R. Gopinath ji.
Thank you, Arma. Thank you. So good morning, friends. Our tradition is somebody says good morning, we say good morning. Somebody says namaskar, we say namaskar. Once again, good morning, friends. Good morning. That's great. Today is a great day, the birthday of a great soul. We'll be indebted to this person as long as the earth, the planet, the sun lives. Look at the statistics over there. 1/10 of his life he spent in jail for our sake. Not because he amassed money, not for that reason. He spent in jail for our sake. A small clipping to show you his willingness to sacrifice. Watch this.
Gandhi believes in early morning exercise. Here we see him returning from his 6 o'clock walk, accompanied by his wife, fourth from the left, and by Admiral Slade's daughter, who is on his right.
The first video press interview given by Mahatma Gandhi.
Mr. Gandhi, you might tell us, please, when you expect to leave for London for the second round table conference.
Oh, I have no notion. And I don't expect to go here if the Hindu-Muslim question is not satisfactorily solved.
If England grants your demands, Mr. Gandhi, do you intend to have complete prohibition in the new Indian state?
Oh, yes.
Absolute prohibition?
Absolute.
And do you intend also, if India wins its independence, to abolish child marriages?
I should very much like to, even before.
If England does not grant your demands, are you prepared to return to jail again?
I am always prepared to return to jail.
The last question asked was, if the queen does not accede to your demand for complete Swarajya, are you prepared to return to jail? And the answer he gave, I am always prepared to go to the jail. A big round of applause to this great person, my dear friends. You call this big applause, is it? Another big round of applause, my dear friend. What a great person he is. That's it. A lot of energy in the morning required. So we go to the topic today with a small tribute to this great person. The topic we're going to discuss today is the purpose. The purpose for what we are... No speaking, please. Don't speak. The purpose. Generally, each one of us will have our own dreams and all. But by and large, the purpose for why we have come into this world, to realize our potential and use it fully, completely use it. Let's say, for example, I go to a petrol pump, ask the petrol attendant, fill up my tank. The tank is full. Now, suppose I take this car and park it into my garage and lock it. What use I have made of the petrol? What difference does it make? Chahe petrol unki tanki mein ho ki hamara tanki mein ho, to farak to padta hi nahi. Because ultimately I didn't use it. So whatever potential we have got in this world, using it fully, realizing it and using it fully. Do you believe that we are little special in our creation when compared to animals? Yes? No? Yes, we are somewhere. Can you give me some examples of how we are special? Any examples of whatever we are special with? We've been given with some special powers, special capacities. Yes, sir? Ma'am? Yeah? We can think, you said it, we can think. And through thinking only, all these inventions have taken place. Anybody else? Anything else special about human beings? Aur bhi koi khas? Any speciality about human being? Visheshta, pratyegata. Sir? Emotion. Sir? Expressing, we can communicate to each other. Emotions, yeah? Bhavne. So we are all having these special qualities. One of the important thing what we can understand is that we are not here by accident. That is for sure. God had some special scheme in his mind when he sent us to this world. Ye to sachi baat. Aise to nahi hai hum kahi hawa mein ud rahe the, suddenly kich aa gaya Gurgaon mein ya ke Kandivili mein ya Borivali mein ya Chennai mein. No. There has been some special idea, a scheme, a design behind our creation. And I strongly believe that we have been equipped and designed to do extraordinary things, not ordinary things. Manishya hone ki nate koi aam kaamyo, koi sadharna karya. No, that is not what we are intended for. Koi saas karke dikhaye, koi aise adbhut cheez karke dikhaye. So do something great, to do something extraordinary. I can give you any number of examples of achievements made extraordinary. In the year 2001, a lady aged 64 climbed Mount Everest. You and I know. Mount Everest is 8,868 meters, almost 9 kilometers. 9 kilometers. Subah 2 kilometers walking hoke aaye na, to aaj subah se itna swas lagta hai. 9 kilometers here, and the age 64. And when she came down, she was asked, ma'am, why did you venture into this? Kya hai upar koi? Is there any treasure up there? Khazana hai koi? Why do you people climb Mount Everest? And you know what she replied? She told, I wanted to celebrate my 64th birthday on the top of the world, and therefore I climbed Mount Everest over there. Extraordinary things, they are extraordinary things. Then the press reporters, they would not, normally they would like to find more, no? How did you start thinking about celebrating birthday on top of the world? Yes, I soch kaise again. You know what she replied? I wanted to prove to this world, age is no limit for any achievement. Fir se bol raha hu. She told, I want to prove to this world that age is no limit for any achievement. A big round of applause to this great person, my dear friends, a lady. 2001, one more person climbed Mount Everest, absolutely blind. Cannot see, Eric Weimer from America. Absolutely blind. Cannot see, even one single inch cannot see. Climbed Mount Everest. 2001, one more record was created on Mount Everest. A person with single arm climbed Mount Everest. This is only simile, only example. Mount Everest is only an example. Could be 20,000 crores turnover for a businessman. Mount Everest is only a simile. It's only an example. For a sports person, becoming Sachin Tendulkar may be a Everest. I mean, Everest is only a simile. Ye koi mountain ki baat nahi kar raha. It is not that all of us should go now and attempt at Mount Everest. No, that's not the point what we are trying to make here. Har ek vyakti ke liye alag alag sa Mount Everest hote hain. Maybe a poet would like to see that he is in comparison with Rabindranath Tagore. I mean, that could be Mount Everest for him. Maybe for a businessman, maybe looking at a global scenario, maybe a Mount Everest. We have been equipped and designed to achieve extraordinary things, to do extraordinary things. Agar humko extraordinary things ke liye rachaya gaya, if we have been srishti, we have been created for that purpose, doing ordinary things in this world is a crime, no, my dear. Doing mediocre life or being an average person doesn't go with our purpose of our creation, no. Now you may ask me, kyun sir, manishya kyun itna special power Bhagwan ne diya? Why has he given? Probably he had something in his mind. He thought, my dear friends, that if I have to bring about improvement in the world, agar duniya mein pragati lana chahunga, so I need somebody to help me in improvement. See, anya cheezon ke liye he created animals, birds, prakriti, panch mahabhuta srishti kiya unhone. It took 2 days for God to create panch mahabhuta, they say. After doing it, God saw, wow, I have done a great job, I created a beautiful world. But he thought, himme kuch kami hai. There's something lacking here. He thought, maybe if I add color, it look more better. And he brought in vegetation, ped pode. When they started flowering out, kilne lage, the world became really colorful. Very happy, yeah. I made it a world, I made it colorful also. Then he thought, okay, color is there. What about movement? Halchal ka? What do I do for movement? Then he created birds and animals. Jab pakshiya udne lage, praniya firne lage, duniya mein movement aage. So God was very happy, yeah. I created the world, colored it, now it is moved also. Then he thought, what about improvement? Kaun karega improvement? Who will bring about improvement? Can I come every day from heaven to do this improvement? No, not possible for me. Therefore, let me create another living being almost with equal power like me, meaning like God, and send him into the world. They will go and improve the world. So thinking, he created you and he created me. We have come into this world to make improvements into this world, my dear friends. A big round of applause to the great creator and to the human beings, all but everybody sitting here. I can give you any number of examples. 60,000 years before, these birds were constructing the nest like this, their living house, their apartment, whatever you may call it like. 3 BHK, 2 BHK, 1 BHK, whatever you may call it like. Not today, 60,000 years before, ye sahi ho raha tha. Not only in India, in the deep jungles of Congo, everywhere you go, it is like this only, no difference. In 60,000 years, no difference. But look at human beings. From caves, where he has come into. 820 meters above sea level, Burj Khalifa standing over there in Dubai. The topmost apartment over there, my dear friends, was costing around $40 million. See where we have come into. Now you may ask me, sir, because of these creations, what is the improvement which happens in the world? When everybody is trying to achieve great in their own life, they are helping others also. फिर से बोल रहा हूं, कभी भी कोई भी व्यक्ति अपने जीवन में प्रगति के लिए कोशिश करेगा, along the side is helping others also. Let me ask you one question. Who invented bulb, my dear friends? Electric bulb? Yep. Thomas already said, you said it, right? That's right. Is it that only he and his generations, they are using the bulb? Everybody is benefited today. Somebody invented how to fly, the flying machine. The flying hawk was it called by the Wright brothers. Is it because they only, is it that their children, their grandchildren, they are only using it? No, all of us are benefited. And that is the reason why he created us. Let me ask you a question. Why are we here in this world then? Why are we in this world? Why are we here in this world? Why have we been sent here? To breathe? To breathe? No, not necessarily. To eat? Of course, some people do it very seriously, of course. Or to sleep? My God, some people when they sleep, you know, they sleep as if they have come into the world only for this purpose. You wake them up morning 8 o'clock, no, they get angry, as if you disturb a research scientist, how much angry he'll become. Utha diya subah 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 ka abhi dupair hone lage. Sleep. Or is it to spend some years, itne saal bite, born on, gone on, bas. Agar ye sab karne hi hai, तो इसमें क्या फर्क पड़ गया दुनिया में अगर हमने ये नहीं करे तो. सपोज वी डोंट ब्रीथ और वी डोंट ईट और स्लीप और नीड टू स्पेंड इयर्स, व्हाट डिफरेंस डज इट मेक टू द वर्ल्ड? मे बी द वर्ल्ड विल बिकम रिचर बाय अ फ्यू औंस ऑफ ऑक्सीजन दैट वी हैव नॉट टेकन. We have not in any way contributed otherwise. I think if not for the purpose of achieving greatness on this planet Earth, our very entry here will be one among so many million incidents happening in the world. Jitne bhi ghatna ghatra prapanch mein, kitne bhi, there are so many lakhon, hundreds, thousands of incidents are happening in this world. And like that, our birth also will be at another incident. Let me demonstrate to you. Look at this lid. It fell down. It dukkan. Here gaya. Bas, that's an incident. It fell down. Is vyakti ka yahan pe janam hua. Bas, dona barabar ka. Bas, yahan gira. Lakhs of incidents are happening in the world. Sometimes some bus starts. Here another person started his life. Bas, itni si baat hai. If not for achieving greatness in this world, my dear friends. In whatever circumstances we may be. Some of us are financially rich. Some of us, we may find some financial challenges. Some of them are emotionally well supported. Some of them may have some emotional issues in life. I mean, everybody has some sort of an issue to face with. But overcoming that and achieving greatness is the purpose for which we have come onto this earth. Am I communicating with all of you? Yes or no? Huh? No. Yeah. Let me give you one such example. Let me ask you one question. 5th September, we celebrated the birthday of a great scholar, philosopher. Yes, sir? You said it, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishna. What do we celebrate his birthday as? Was he your teacher? Was he my teacher? Then why do we celebrate his birthday as Teacher's Day? Said it. He requested, after becoming the president, when the old students of Banaras Hindu University approached him and asked him, sir, we want to celebrate your birthday as in our university in a big way. Then he told, okay, go ahead and celebrate my birthday. But then celebrate it as a teacher's day because I feel the contribution the teacher can make to the country can be far more bigger than what a president might be able to do. Because even this president and prime minister are created by such teachers only. Therefore, celebrate my birthday as teacher's day. I think we must give a big round of applause to this lady, my dear friends, who helped us in understanding that. Ma'am, I thankfully acknowledge what you contributed.